Righty-o then, as you can see there up in front of the camera, I've chosen a bit of test equipment from that case, and right next to that's a cup of tea time. Okay, that's mine, you're not having any. What I will share though is what's inside that case, and we're going to be looking at a clamp meter. Okay, that was previously selected in the last video by the old wiggly finger. Okay, it danced around in that case and then stopped on that. And in today's video, we are now going to be discussing that. And it is a clamp meter in there. Just having a little sip of my tea there, just to make sure my throat doesn't dry out, because, you know, it's not very good if that happens in the middle of the video. So, let's get it out of the case then. I'm just going to unzip it on camera, just to make sure I've got it up the correct way, and it's, you know, up the right way, not upside down, back to front and inside out. Right, it is up the correct way then. Let's pull that zip all the way around. Okay then, what have we got inside then? What does this clamp meter look like? Well, you're just about to find out. There it is. Now, I've got something to say about this one. I purchased this as a used unit. Okay, this pouch came with it. Those test probes come with it. You know, I've got a feeling the previous owner looked after it reasonably well, because, well, we've got all the case with it, all the test leads, instruction manuals in there too. So, yeah, I've got a feeling they looked after it reasonably well. Why they sold it, I don't know. Maybe they wanted to upgrade to a better model. That happens. And there we go. So let's dig it out of there then. And there we go. We've got instruction manual. And all the probes with it. We'll have a look at the probes and the instruction manual a bit later. Let's just put that over there then. So, clamp meter then. What have we got? Right, what we got then on this one? There it is. So what we're going to be looking at then in this video is an AlphaTech, and it is a Tech 837. Okay, now just before getting to this, right, a little rip-off alert. This is also sold under the Dialog name, exactly the same units. Okay, I speak through experience, because I have previously before now owned a Dialog 6404 and I popped it. Okay, I inadvertently done something with it, spat a bit of voltage up back up into it and blew it. Then I got, you know, in replacement to that, a Dialog DL6402. Okay, you can see that if you go in the test on playlist. And then sometime after that, this come up for sale as a used unit, and I grabbed it because I know of the functions associated with the DL6404, which is the Dialog. And I done a bit of shopping around, you know. I went on the old internet, had a good old look around. And the really weird thing is, although the Tech 837 is exactly the same unit as the Dialog DL6404, if you purchase the Dialog equivalent of this, you're going to get a bit stung, basically. This one, exactly the same unit, is considerably cheaper. I don't know why that is. Exactly the same unit. Okay, so if you, after I've discussed this, if you like this and you think, yeah, I'm going to get one, go for the AlphaTech 837. Okay, not the Dialog DL6404, because you're going to get stung. Exactly the same unit. It looks the same, it functions the same, everything about it's the same except the brand and the model number that's on it. Okay, so just, you know, a little rip-off alert there. If you want to save a few pennies and you like this, then get the AlphaTech 837 and not the Dialog equivalent. So let's get into it then, and we'll have a look at all the features and functions, bells and whistles and whatnot. I might even turn it on and make the screen light up. How about that? Let's get a bit of zoom on that selection dial then. Okay, right down the bottom. Then it says off, mainly because it is. Okay, there it is. So you rotate this, and that little arrow there goes up around here. So we've got off, and then it says auto power off. So if you leave this turned on, after a little while, it will self time out and save the battery from just being totally worn out. Next one up then, if you rotate this to that little dot just there, you can measure volts and hertz. Okay, this will measure alternating current and direct current. Okay, so you turn it around, and then down there you've got the mode buttons. You've got to press the mode button, and it will change between alternating current and direct current. Okay, if you turn it around one more, there's a variety of functions that can do. Okay, you've got continuity on there, diode check, and measure resistance. Okay, if you turn it up one more, it can measure capacitance. Okay, if you turn it around one more, you've got temperature. Okay, with this one, if you go down here once again and press the mode button, you can change the screen between Celsius and Fahrenheit. Okay, with I think it's the DL6402 of the Dialog one, where it says temperature and capacitance, if you actually got temperature down there and it says Celsius, and up here it says temperature Fahrenheit. On this one, they bundled the Celsius and Fahrenheit into one location and moved the capacitance from here up to here. Okay. When you turn it up one more, it then goes into a completely different mode and it starts measuring amps. Okay, so you've got 40 amps there. I think on this, the minimum is 10 milliamps. So anywhere between 10 milliamps and 40 amps, it's that one. Turned it up one more, 400 amps. If you go right up the top, 1,000 amps. And like it says there, it measures in alternating current and direct current on the clamp there. Okay, so how does that work then? Well, you get an electric cable. Suppose my finger's the electric cable. Okay, you open that up, get it around the cable like that. Okay, and what happens is this electric cable, which is through there, what happens basically is there'll be a magnetic swell forming around that cable. And that magnetic field built up in this, and then it's translated through the electronic hocus pocus in there and shows up on the readout display down the bottom there. Okay, that's basically how it works. And this can measure direct current as well as alternating current. Some of them, like the DL6403, which is Dialog, they don't do direct current on the clamp. This one does. Okay. Also with this, if I just get that down the bottom there, there you go, it says AC and DC, true RMS clamp meter. Okay, so the Dialog equivalent of this, the 6401 and 6402, they're not true RMS, but the 6403 and 6404 are. Okay, and this is a true RMS one, and the Dialog equivalent of this is the DL6404. Okay, what we're looking at is the AlphaTech, and it's a Tech 837. Okay, like I said at the rip-off alert, if you like this, get the AlphaTech one, not the Dialog, and you'll save yourself a few pennies on exactly the same unit. Okay, so we've got all that then. Hold button. When you measure on there, either amps or voltage or whatnot, when you get a number come up on the screen, if you press that, it will freeze the screen. Okay, if you're measuring amps, you can take that off the cable, and it doesn't matter where this is, the readout will stay stuck on the screen so you can read it. That can be handy if you've got a hefty great cable going through there, it's look over to the side like that, and you can't really see the screen. You would put that on the cable, leave it on there to measure up for a little bit, press the hold button, take that off the cable, and then it doesn't matter where this is, what you measured, it will be shown on the screen so that you can see it and maybe write it down or something. Okay, very handy, that little hold button. Okay. The other buttons then on that, we've got the mode button. Remember I said about the mode button? That allows you to select between things like AC and DC if you're measuring voltage, or AC and DC if you're measuring amps on the clamp there. Okay. With this one, we've got a peak function. Okay, what that does is you press that when you're measuring, like, amps, for example. And this display, it will measure up. So you go 1 amp, 2 amp, 3 amp, 4 amp, 20 amp, 30 amp, 45 amps. And then if you was to turn the power off, what would happen is this would actually stay at what it measured at the peak. Okay. And you'd be able to press that and it would say on there, you know, the peak measurement was 45 amps or whatnot. Okay. Very handy that. That button there with a little light bulb on it, if you press that, the screen lights up. I'll do that in a moment. And of course you've got a zero function on there. And you press that and you can zero the screen. Okay. So let me just turn it on. We're not going to be putting any test probes in this and taking measurements or whatnot. We're just doing a general discussion on this test equipment. We'll do a demo in another video on another day. So, you know, you'll have to tune in for that. But we're just going to turn this on. There we go. And we got DC on there, DC volts, because that's what I've turned it on. If you want this on AC, you've got to press the mode button. Okay. And that is currently 19 millivolts. Don't worry about that. I'm just going to demonstrate the little button there. Press that and screen lights up. Okay. There's 21.1 millivolts, even though there isn't anything connected in there. I'm not sure we can zero that. There you go. You can sort of zero it. But, you know, doesn't quite do it. But there it is. It's all on there. And there we go. And again, if you leave that like that, after a while it will time out and turn off. But you can manually turn off just by doing that. Okay. So that's all the buttons and things on it then. Let me just turn that back off. Those holes down the bottom there, that's where you connect your test probes in. Whether you're doing voltage, continuity, diode, capacitance, or your temperature. Okay. You connect your temperature test probes in there. Okay, you do actually need an additional bit of test equipment to put in there so that you can take your temperature, mainly being the temperature probe. Okay, this, as it is, won't detect any temperature at all. You do need to connect it in there. I've got it in a case. We'll have a look at that in a moment or two. Okay, so yes, AlphaTech then. It's a Tech 837. Like I've already said, the equivalent unit to this is a Dialog DL6404. And if you like this unit and you're thinking about buying one, get the AlphaTech and you'll save yourself a fair old few pennies. Okay, the DL6404 and the Tech 837, exactly the same units. There is a difference with the price though. Okay, little rip-off alert there. Make sure you don't get stung and get the AlphaTech Tech 837. And there we are. So what I'm going to do right about now then, I'm going to break off, because my cup of tea's getting cold, look. Okay, I'm going to break off, have some of my tea. When we come back, we'll have a look for that instruction manual, have a look at all those test probes and all that lot, what you get with it, and we'll go from there. Okay, you can have a cup of tea as well with me if you want, so, you know, we'll nip off or break, and then we'll come back a bit later. Here it is then. Thanks for coming back after the break. What we're now going to be looking at is the instruction manual to get with that, and the test probes, and the temperature measurement little probe tip as well. Okay, so let's open it up then. There's the bit of test equipment. We've already looked at that in the previous section. There's the instruction manual. And the test probes. Now, I don't know why. Oh, there it is. It is in there. I just thought it had gone. So there's the test probe, the temperature test probe then. Right. Let me just put the case to one side. It is there. Okay. Just there. So, test probe's information in voltage. It does appear I've got a couple of bits missing, actually. Because, really speaking, that on there, you see all that test probe on there, there should be an additional little tip cover that goes on that. And it should only be about that much of the test probe that you can see. Okay, that is for GS38 reasons. Okay, because if you add that in, like, say, a control panel or something, and there's another terminal right next to that, and let's say, for example, let's use this one then. Okay, let's say, for example, this is alive, and right next to that you've got the neutral, and this reached across and touched the other terminal, there would be a hefty great bang. Okay, what you should have on that is a little cover which clips down to this finger guard, and it covers all of that up, and you've only got that much of the test probe showing, just so you can touch it on the terminal to get, you know, the voltage. And of course, if you've only got that much touch and it can't reach across and touch the other terminal, okay, and then cause a bit of a big bang, because, you know, if that happens, you know, you're obviously going to damage your eyesight, because it's going to be quite a bright flash. You probably damage your hearing as well, because it's going to be quite loud. And that test probe there will be totally obliterated, melted, and be bits of it buried into your face, which wouldn't be nice. Okay, so really speaking, there should be covers on there, but they, you know, this being a used unit, they're obviously missing. Okay, I don't think they're in the case. No, regrettably, they're not. Oh dear. So, yes. Given that there are sort of oily, greasy marks on this, it might have been used in, you know, looking at in a mechanics garage type of thing. I don't know where this was used, okay, but it might have been used in a mechanics garage or something where it's, you know, it's only maximum 24 volts. And he was using it for checking continuity, and being you can do direct current on the clamp, he might have been using this to see how many amps the starter motor uses and things like that. Perfectly legitimate operation and function for that. Okay, you get a big old hefty cable around there coming off the car battery, turn the engine over, and whatever that starter motor uses, it'll measure it on there, because this can do direct current. Perfect use for that. And of course, you know, he's obviously taken those off, they've gone somewhere, he's lost them. And well, that's what I've got now. Okay, set of test leads without the little tips on this. I really shouldn't be using these on mains voltages. Okay, if I do, be very careful not to make sure that these don't get across another terminal and cause a big bang. Okay, so they can be used for testing voltage, continuity, capacitance, diodes, all of that. You just touch that on whatever needs to be checked, making sure you choose the correct function and mode and all that lot on there, and you get your test result come up on screen. Well, on the other end then, you've obviously got these. Okay, they obviously go in there. The red one goes in the red hole, and the black one goes in the black hole, like that. Okay, again, we're not going to be doing tests and measurements on this. I'm just putting that in there to show you what goes where. Okay, so there we are. So that's those then. You get these supplied with that when you buy one, with the little tip covers on the test probes, of course. With this is your temperature measurement device. Okay, with that, it can go in that tester either way around, so you do have to make sure you put it in around the correct way, otherwise you get funky readings. If I get a little zoom on that for you, you can see on there it's got a plus and a minus. Okay, there's your minus symbol there, and there's your plus sign there. With the plus sign, that would be this pin over here, that will go in the red one, and obviously speaking, the minus one, which is this, would go in the black hole. Okay, if you get that around the wrong way, like I say, you will get funky readings, and you don't want that. And then that little little pip on the end of there. That's what detects the temperature. So you put it on something which is warm or cold. Say, for example, the casing of a motor or something like that. And it will measure the temperature. And it will display it on that screen in your chosen unit of measurement, which will be either Celsius or Fahrenheit. Let's look in the instruction manual. Now, interestingly, on this, it doesn't say, on the front of here anyway, it doesn't say what model this is, and it certainly doesn't say it on there, which somehow suggests to me that these are manufactured by some company, and, you know, look, for example, Dialog buy 1,000 of them and put Dialog on there. AlphaTech have purchased a load and put their brand name on there, so on and so forth, and I do know that I have seen this particular model under at least three different brand names. There is one where that clamp is like a red colour, okay, and that's red in there as well. And I can't remember what, I think it's called Handyman, something like that. And Handyman also used the same model number, which is Tech 837, or it would be Handyman 837 or something like that. And the clamp is like a red colour, and all that lot. So this clamp reader is available under at least three different brand names, which says to me that these are manufactured by just some company somewhere, unbranded, and then, you know, one company will buy 1,000, and then Dialog buys 1,000, and then AlphaTech buys 1,000 and puts their brand name on it, and then they go to sale. Okay, which probably explains why rip-off alert once again. This one, exactly the same unit as a Dialog, it costs a fair old bit cheaper than the Dialog equivalent, so if you like that, then get the AlphaTech version. You'll save yourself a few pennies. Right, we've got all that in there then. Again, I'm not going to whiz through this too detailed. But, yes, let's have a quick whiz through that, because I'm pretty sure there will be certain things in here which it will say on here will not apply with the other model. I know it does in the Dialog books, because you'll have, as an example, if this was suited for Dialog ones, it would say up the top there, DL6303 and DL6404. And in those, let's say for example you open this up and it says how to measure DC amps. On that it would then say in brackets DL6404 only, because the 6403 cannot measure direct current on the clamp. So let's have a look through that and see if it says some other model which does not apply, you know, certain functions on it. It doesn't apply to the other model. Interestingly, it doesn't. Okay, as an example at the top here, if this was a Dialog instruction manual, it's up top, it says DC current. Well, if this was a Dialog instruction manual, it would say DC current, and then in brackets it would say DL6404 only. Okay, because this instruction manual would be suited for 6403 and 6404, and the bits and pieces in there which would be suited for the DL6404 only, it would say it next to that. So it would say in there DC current, and then in brackets DL6404 only. But I've got a feeling this instruction manual is actually made for that particular model only, which is a Tech 837. And there we are. So, yes. So again, it just shows you all the various different things in there. See here, for example, it shows you how to check the voltage on a battery. And that you just connect that in there, turn it around to volts, make sure it's on direct current on there, so on and so forth. You know, and they've even put on the display that 13.16 for that battery. You know. And there you go, you've got one for measuring alternating current as well. So there we go. And again, there'll be other things in there, like measuring for hertz, using the temperature measurement probe, it's all in there. Diode measurements, continuity. Again, it's got a buzzer in it as well, so when you're doing continuity and you do get a good reading, it buzzes. And all of that lot. I'd like to think of thinking it shows you how to measure the amps. I might have gone past that page or missed it out or something like that. Yes, it does. So there you go. DC current measurement. And then it shows you how to do it down there. Again, with this, there is a correct way and an incorrect way of doing it. And this one's the correct way, because like I said, you'd have a magnetic field coming off that cable, and it would form in that clamp, and then it's translated by an electronic mambo-jambo and come out on there. Now, if you've done that, what would happen is the current would go through one conductor in one direction, come back the other way in the other direction. One cancels out the other, so you'd get zero on the screen. Okay, and if I've actually shown it on there. See, 14.58 amps on there for the correct one. And for that one, because that's incorrect, it'll be zero, because one conductor would cancel the other out. And there we go. Okay. So, yeah, it's the same with alternating current one as well. Okay, correct way and incorrect way. Okay, so you only put one conductor through that clamp at a time. And there we go. So that's the instruction manual then for the AlphaTech Tech 837. Hope you enjoyed watching this one. I've got to put all that stuff back in the case now. So I'm going to put all this back in the case, as it should be. Because, you know, I obviously look after my test equipment, as did the previous owner of this piece of test equipment.